New jazz. Who ever heard of that? Except from reading the program? Whoever did a project with Vue.js? Okay, goodbye. That's a lot, actually. Who is familiar with JavaScript in here? Which frame? That's also most of the people here. Who is using jQuery? Yeah, Marco?
Reluctantly.
A bit.
Or it's half a finger.
See, as Dimitris is not here, what are you thinking of jQuery? Normally I wanted to ask that Dimitris, but I asked that...
I'll be Dimitris. It sucks. You shouldn't use it.
No. There's a special word with Dimitris.
I don't care. It works for me, so... It looks slow in places.
Maybe I wanted to hack crap. No. So, jQuery. So, who used Mutu in this room? Maybe that are the legacy people.
Joomla 1.5
and 1.02.
Yeah.
Long times ago. See, the web the web evolved since then, and now we have new modern shiny JavaScript frameworks every day we get a new one. But one of the most popular is Vue.js. Actually it's written Vue, but it's spoken like the Vue. And so like Vue. And yeah, let's get started. So we have some slides and after that we go to a presentation. Mm-hmm. So we start with what's Vue. So Vue is an open source JavaScript framework for building user interfaces. That's important. It's only about user interfaces. It focuses, you can integrate it in different ways. That's important too. I'm going to show only one today, but there's some other ways too. You can combine it with, you can and often you have to combine it with other JavaScript libraries. For example, you can even combine it with jQuery. So what's Vue? Vue is really the front-end part. If you need to do XHR queries, Ajax requests, you need to use other libraries. And for everything else too. That's a big difference to, for example, Angular. Angular is a full stack. Who heard of Angular? Okay, so I don't have to explain so much. So Angular is a full stack framework. Even for XHR requests, Ajax requests, you have a library in there, you have a state in there, all that stuff around it. In Vue.js, you have to build it yourself. But that makes Vue.js really, really small. And that's one of the things why Vue.js is a good option to start with top-notch, high-end JavaScript frameworks. It's also very lightweight. If you have an Angular project, it's default Angular project, just with the basic Angular components, you get easily way above 300-400 kilobytes compressed. With Vue.js, it's just 21 kilobytes. Less than jQuery. jQuery is 30. Vue.js is reusable, so no more really big, huge jQuery JS files with this big code blocks. Vue.js can use E6 modules. That's important. That's something we're going to look at a bit later. And it's maintainable. So we can split our code. Just like, who has some experience with Joomla component development? Well, that's also quite a few. So just like Joomla component development, you can split up your application, your web application, into multiple parts. Ah, Mr. Dimitris, you missed your part.
You can ask him the question now.
Yeah, what do you think of jQuery?
Yeah, it's the best thing ever happened.
See, perfect.
I love it.
See, what's it all about? When you go to the Vue.js website, you see the slogan, progressive JavaScript framework. Anyone has any idea what that should mean? That's just really not a really accessible slogan. It's a hard one. And what that means is Vue.js is that small, that easy to implement. You can use it on a single page. You can, for example, for a contact form or for some gallery like Robert wrote some days ago. Or you can develop a whole application with it. But if you develop a whole web application, we're talking about multiple sites, multiple tasks, multiple components, you need other application stacks for that, which are there in the Vue ecosystem, like the Vue Router or Vue.x. So, Vue.js and numbers. Numbers are always a nice thing in JavaScript. It's not always a guarantee that it's a good one, sadly. But we have 93,000 stars for Vue.js. So it's a big one. If you compare that to our to the Joomla stars, we sadly just have 2,730. So don't forget to star Joomla, if you didn't yet. Important. We have 100 only, and that's really only, if you look at Angular, they have around 3,000 open issues. We have only 119 open issues in Vue.js, which is really good number for a framework that big. Joomla has around 400 at the moment, if I recall correctly. But there's one point for Joomla is better. We have more contributors than Vue.js. See, when we're talking about modern JavaScript frameworks nowadays, you mostly choose front-end JavaScript frameworks. You mostly choose between Angular, React, and Vue.js. And for beginners, Vue.js is the easiest way to go in. For example, I started some years ago with Angular, and that was really, really hard to find the way into. Took me weeks because of completely new concepts, things which weren't documented, really hard. And Vue.js is different. And that's why we are looking at that now. So, what do you need to get Vue.js running on your local computer? You need Git, that's important, but everyone should have Git anyways. You need Node. Who does not know what Node is? Okay, everyone knows. Who has Node installed on their computers? That's almost all the rest should install it. There, even besides Vue, there are some useful things with it. And we don't need a web server to develop a Vue application. That's a really nice thing. So, getting started, I told in the beginning already there are multiple ways of integrating Vue.js. We are going to use a rapid development application approach and use a pre-configured helper, and we use Webpack. The nice thing you're going to see that soon is hot reloading. Anyone heard of hot reloading? Okay, that's not so many, that's interesting, because when you come from the PHP world, you're used to different things. Okay, we look at that in a second. So here's the repo link. It's an official Vue.js template which gets you started with Webpack. It brings a lot of stuff with it. You can choose what you want. And the easiest way to get your application running is to first install the Vue command line application. Every big framework, JavaScript framework nowadays has one thing like that. Even PHP has that with Artisan, for example, in Laravel. So, and after that, you just do a Vue init. That's what we are doing in some seconds. So, let's get started. Enough presentations. Let's get some code done. So, you start with on the command line. It can also.
Can you increase?
Okay, that's really small. Okay, but it's just one command I need to type. And anyways, we start with Vue init webpack. And what can we do? We do a session app. So you use a famous sample of any JavaScript application is always a to-do list. We do something like that too, but maybe a bit more interesting. So we call our project job 18 session app. so long. JEP 18 session. That's fine. So if you see the command line is scaffolding some code for us. I know it's a bit small, can't change that so fast. So after that, we are almost ready. We can use ESLint, testing, all that things. We don't need that now. So, and it does the npm install. So we're going to take a look at that in a second. So that's the scaffolding, and after that we have a Vue.js project running ready. So we go to PHP Storm, open that project. Where did I put that? So, and we got a lot of stuff. Is this readable or should I make it a bit larger, maybe? Resolution is really not so nice. So everyone can read that, even in the back. So that's what the Vue command line generated for us. A lot of stuff, way too much stuff, and we don't even have to care so much about it. Actually, the code of the project which it generated is really small. So we are going to ignore build now, we are going to ignore config now, not node modules, and so on. We're just going to take a look at the source folder. So first let's get our project running. For that you need again a terminal, command line, whatever you're using. And you type in here npm run development, because we are currently in development mode. And this is going to start up a web server, a node web server, on which we can see our application. So next we go to localhost, and that's here, node application. Not very exciting. See, first let me explain the concept of hot reloading. I'm going to remove that logo file here, because we don't need it anyways. And I'm not going to do anything else. And I'm going to go back to the browser. And you see, the browser got automatically refreshed. The content in the browser got refreshed. That's called hot reloading, because it's reloaded on the fly on any file change. That makes developing applications really nice. For PHP, there are some extensions, browser extensions out there. On Mac, for example, Live Reload, I think, is the most popular. But in Node, this is integrated out of the box. So, what do we have here? Our application is separated into different files, and the entry point is always the app.view. The view entry point. The application entry point is, of course, the main JS file, which is not really interesting, so not much you have to change at the beginning, at least not. So let's focus on the app.view. In the app.view, or in any view file, in any view component, the file here is separated into three parts. We have the template, which is our output. We have the script, which is our business logic, code, and our data, so our model too. And we have the CSS. So first thing, I'm going to remove this. I'm going to make that a bit smaller. And session app. Okay, what can we do? In the template, you write normal HTML. Just basic plain HTML with some things, component styles, and some other placeholders you can put in here. So let's start with some basic HTMLs. Let's start with a heading session. So And our goal is you should have a form where you can add the sessions for Jane Beyond you want to watch in the next days. And this is safe then. So we don't have an Ajax API, but we still could save it, for example, as a cookie in the session and to other things. So what do we need for that when we think on such an application? We need a way to input something. We maybe need a way to edit something. We can combine these two later. And we need some output. And we maybe need a way to say, hey, I watched this session already. I don't want it any longer on my list. So session is done. We could also do dates, but that's way too complicated. So we could start writing everything in here. So we can have one single flat file with all our HTML code, with all our application. But that's not the idea of Vue. In Vue, you separate every part as much as you can. So we see this nice line here, the router view. That sounds actually totally weird for most people. And the router view is actually replaced through what we asked for here. You see the URL here, we have localhost here, that's our local machine. After that, we have a router, hash, of course, hash, and after that, a slash. What's the thing which is after the hash is the URL we try to open in Vue. So if I change that to, for example, test, we would now try to open the test. We don't have a file or a root for test. So it's just going to change, show the stuff which we have on the app view, because this is the entry point. But we could have different URLs too. So that's the router view. So, and how is the router view working? The router view is replaced through our hello world.view file. So, we can start modifying that file. Personally, I'm going to rename that file because I really don't like the name Hello World View. And let's start with session list view. So let's do a refactor. And we see we have a compiling error because a file is no longer found. So let's take a look at the router. That's the configuration of our routes. They are more or less static, but you are able to have parameters just like you used in normal get parameters, which is not so common, but you can use them here. So here's our issue. We see we have hello world everywhere in here. So we need to change that to our new session list. So, who's not familiar with E6 models and the import tag? Okay, so import is basically something we load other project files, in this case from the Vue project and from the router project, into this file. It's basically like a require include in PHP. So it's modelizing and it's the JavaScript code. That makes modern web applications even possible, because else you would have 100 script tags, whatever, in a site. Import statement makes it way easier. So, working again. So in this we have a lot of stuff again, which I'm just going to remove. And we have a lot of CSS at the moment too. I'm going to make that really simple. So what we want to do now in the template, let's call it sessions, is we want to output, select the sessions, put in sessions. We don't have any at the moment. So when you have multiple of one thing, what would be the best data type in JavaScript?
Arrays.
So we're going to have arrays, and for arrays you need then loops to iterate over them and to look at them. So let's take finally a look at the script part of the site. We have export default, we have a name which is totally optional. There are some places which are not really used, but it's mostly for intern identifiers. So you can even skip the name thing. It's just a typical conversion of Vue.js. But I'm going to just change it to session list. After that, we have a data. And data is a message which is returning our state, our variables which are saved in there. And we say we have just a message there. If you have things like that, you can then use this stuff you have in here, the data, in your template. So if you would like to use that, you would do it like the following trick syntax, late syntax. And we can just put in message in here. That's basic sample hut. That would be the result. So I'm going to remove it anyways, and I'm going to remove it. So we said we have an array. An empty array for the beginning. So before we render the sessions, we actually need to create some sessions, because else we don't have to show anything except that create some fake sessions here. So for now, I'm going to make another component from it a bit later. For now, let's put it in here. So let's have a div ID session add, whatever. Session create, session add. And what do we have? We need an input field, for sure. And maybe it would be nice to have a button too, to add it. Why not? Nothing really exciting that we have said now. Yeah, whatever. Session title. Okay, finally. So now we have to add some view logic to it. So we could start easily, and we could introduce a new variable in here. Let's call it session input and make it empty for the beginning. And now we want to bind the session input, what's in here, to our input field. So it's all about data binding. But I'm going to just show it. So we do a V model. I'm going to explain that a bit later, but it's pretty obvious once you see it in action what's going to happen. So I'm going to bind that to a model, and I'm going to put something in here just for testing, just for evolution. So, and as you can see, our placeholder disappears, and what we have in the data variable is in there. So what do we need next? Functionality, because we need to do something if you click on the button. Add this one, the input, to the sessions. So something needs to happen here on the button. And for that, we need methods. So we need to introduce a new area in here. So we do methods. And let's call our method add session. So it's a function.
Typing on this laptop. No, I have a typo somewhere.
Methods function. detection. No, it's actually alright.
No.
That's actually right. Racy complaining. Anyone sees a typo? I forgot the double point. Here it's an object. That's different. That's a thing you need to just remember. Methods is different than data. Methods is an object you give to Vue.js, and data you return something, so it's a function. So we have a method at session, and what do we need to do? We need to put the value of session input in there, so the session input. Another thing which would be probably nice is we're going to reset this session input to zero. So we make it clear again. So let's see what's happening. So let's type in test. Let's click on that. Nothing is happening. Because now the next step is I need to bind that method to our template again. So here to the button. We need to do a V on. Click. So, and what do? We do an add session. Prevent, if you have a form, you need to do prevent. In our case, we wouldn't need to, but it's always good to have a prevent. It's a prevent event default. You know that from other jobs.
Is there a result or a window?
Yeah. So, let's do that. Okay, we don't show anything, but at least our test disappears after we clicked on it. Great functionality. Say the next thing is we need to render these, and for that we need a loop, and for that we have a template syntax in Vue.js 2. So for every session of sessions, we do a loop, and we start easy, or we do a diff element first. We start easy. I'm just for testing. We just put it out here. So we switch back, type in test, and see if something is happening. Two times asked there. So, okay. So basically, you can see this is a really nice thing about Vue.js. You can have dynamic stuff added and written really fast. With an Angular project, we would have taken hours to get that achieved. Not because it's more complicated to write in Angular, but it's so more complicated to set it up, to get it done, and so on. So let's continue a bit with that. That's not really looking nice. So I said we maybe want to somehow remove sessions again from the list, as we have them there forever. So we can either delete them or save them for later, so it's a nice list. But then we need to store more in a session than just the text. We need to store some state. It was visited or not. So how could we do that? Instead of putting a string into the sessions, we can build whole objects. So JavaScript makes it really easy to put an object into here. Say we put in title and we put in a visited or done, whatever. Done is false. So we extend what we push in the arrays. We push objects in the array. Everyone knows what an object is in JavaScript, don't you? Let's be optimistic. So we put this in, And now we have to change our rendering because we can't use session anymore. We have an object here. We need to use session title. And what else can we do? We can maybe, let's really make it simple. We just make a checkbox for now. And we again use remodel. That's a data binding. Session done. Let's see, look at the result. Let's do a test. And now we have a checkbox test. It's not checked. Let's do another one. And it again happens nothing. So what could we do next? We could say we only render this one when the session is not done yet. So we first have only open not visited sections. And for that we need the next thing, a logic thing, and that's reif. So we say session
done.
I would have written it like that, but we can write it different ways. Not true, because it's not done. Then we put it in here. So let's see if that is already working. So we do a test, do a second test. And I'm going to check that. And you see, it disappears instantly once I check the checkbox. I don't even need to write a re-click method. I don't even need to bind is checked or selected, whatever, depends on the field. There, view takes care of that. See, this is a real nice advantage of view. Then we could, what else can we show?
Show the done tasks, already done tasks.
Okay, we can show the done tasks. But we maybe should hide them first. So maybe we're showing them below the button. I really hate that keyboard. So we're showing them behind the button. And we're going to just show it if some, oh, we make a button first, come on, easy. Button old sessions. So when we click this button, we want to show what's coming in, coming there. So first let's see what we want to render. So I'm going to make a new div with an ID, old sessions. And in there, I know it's duplicate code. I'm just going to copy that. I'm not going to show the input box. I'm not even going to use that. That's not necessary. It's reformat. And, oh, it's actually necessary as the way we wrote it. Session done equals to, it's really too much duplicate code, not really nice. We do session title. So for now, it shows it directly and not only when it's done. So if I check this here, we have it down here as a text. So we need to react to an event again. You click on the button, something needs to happen. And this one needs to be hidden by default. So multiple ways in jQuery, you would now use jQuery hide or toggle or show, whatever. In our case, we do a reif and say show old. That's the name of a data variable we're going to introduce in a second. So let's introduce that and set it by default to false. And we need another method for that. You could even do it inline, but I hate inline JavaScript, so let's make a method. So we do show old, or we even make it easier, we do toggle old, and it's a really, really simple method. We just do this show old equals this show old. So now we need to go again to our template and bind it to the button. So we on the button we do again, and I'm again in insert mode. We do a V on, click prevent, and we do a toggle hold. Somehow deleted that. Okay, so first let's add again two test sessions. Get rid of one, it's not shown at the moment. And once we click on the button old session, it's shown. Once we click again on it, it's gone again.
Magic.
So yeah, that's basically it in Vue. And everything is about that. You can build a lot of...
I'm just going to say, like, you just use one component there, right? So you could use build
yes.
up different components and put them into another page.
Yeah.
This
should be a component, probably.
Yeah.
This should be a component. Yeah. These things we would split up in more components. We can do that for example.
Sorry, you do things like calculating things when the page is first loaded, so that button wouldn't appear if there were no old items, for example.
We can do that too. We just have to say, okay, let's do that first. After that, we can refactor a bit more. We can just add a V if, and we can say sessions length equals zero. Or not equal zero. Yeah. Okay, that's not an indicator that we have old sessions, because normally we would need to check every event, is it done or not, and have a counter of done or not done events if you want to really make that nice. So we could do a method count done sessions. If that returns more than zero, we show the button. If not, we do. That's the easy workaround, which helps a bit, but it's not a good solution. So that makes sure the button is not shown at the beginning.
Show it in the browser. Add one,
and it's sadly shown then, because we don't look is the session active or not, or a session.
But wouldn't it be better to check whether there's a disabled session on it?
Yeah, but we need to look in every session, and we need to iterate about over our array then, and take a look of the session status. Or we integrate
but
the status.
But this is impossible, I mean, it's for usability. I mean.
We can either count, or we could integrate
a new
variable.
How should this store the data? Where should I store the data? Not just in the browser. As a cookie, what would you suggest?
Of the sessions.
Yeah, if you want to look tomorrow, what task I have
around.
HTML5 web storage, for example,
okay.
In a database.
What do you prefer? What do you
a database, of
database.
Course. Because else it's only saved in the single browser. But it all depends what you're doing.
Yeah.
For example, I don't know if you even know that the Giant Beyond website, it's not using Vue.js, it's using Angular,
yeah.
Has a nice bookmark feature of sessions.
Session.
And that's using the local storage, the local browser storage. You had a question, yeah?
Yeah, I've been using Polymer quite a lot. And this looks like a light version of that.
It is, yeah. It's really in this direction. But actually,
why not just use Polymer and get all the power from that?
Because this
pre-built web components like
because this is
Ajax and stuff like that.
Because this has a different target. as I said in the beginning, this is about user interface only. It wants to be lightweight. So lightweight, you can put it in into your Joomla installation easily, into your WordPress site, and so on. You can develop really nice stuff with Vue. There's a lot of nice sample projects. You can even develop Chrome extensions with it. Here's one I wrote, for example. Maybe I should not show that, but that is a Chrome extension written in Vue.js. And you can do a lot of stuff with Vue.js. Yeah. So. And this one is using, for example, a REST API in the background, and some caching. So
you wrote your own LastPass code.
Yeah. If you ever look at LastPass codes, you know why.
How can you look at it?
Chrome extensions, you can look at their code. They are written in JavaScript and HTML, and in Chrome extensions, this way you can also use Vue.js, like on that. So we are almost out of time. I'm going to show one more thing, which is going to bring us also into, on Sunday, I have another session called Integrating Webpack Applications into JavaScript Applications into a PHP application. So the whole time we're running our local server, node server in here now. The next step now would be deploy it to a Joomla site or to a HTML site or whatever you want. We don't use any node features except the server in here, so you can perfectly use this app as a web page. So that would be the next topic. I'm just going to show the command for these ones which are not going to be there on Sunday. It would be npm run build. And what's actually happening now, it bundles our project, all files, all CSS, whatever, into one big, or three big files, and puts it here in the, let me refresh, in the disk folder. And if you, that's really bad, if you want to use it then in Joomla, you basically just need these things you see there. Manifest, vendor, app. You can even use them, load them with JHTML and join document. And the CSS one. We didn't do any CSS, but it would be included too. But we look at that on Sunday. I'm going to explain it a bit more. But that's basically it on Vue. And we are almost out of time, so questions, things you want to see maybe in the last 5 minutes.
I'm wondering about databases. So I need another extension for this, or?
It's just front-end JavaScript. If you want to access a database, you either need a REST API or you, when you are on Node, you can use a Node database layers. There are so many like waterfall. Without Node, you need the REST. You're in the front end, you're in the browser.
Okay.
You don't want to tell the user your database credentials, so no. It's about JavaScript. JavaScript is not for getting data. Node is. Node JavaScript. But not. This is client side JavaScript. So you need to build a REST API, whatever.
Yeah.
Or just use browser storage. Any other questions? What? Where you do the?
Data validation possibilities before
yes.
Forms are submitted as well.
Yes, like in normal JavaScript. Actually, you don't really submit forms with. You don't have so many forms in Vue.js. You just bind it again. So if you, for example, if you want to save something from a form to a database with XHR requests, whatever. We don't even would submit or serialize, if you know jQuery, you mostly serialize the form. No, you would have it, you have the data bind to a data variable down here, one or multiple, one is mostly better, one big object. And then you send the object, JSON stringify, to the API. Okay, then thank you very much.